Nice view, huh? I used to come here a lot before.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
Do all androids ask so many personal questions, or is it just you?
I saw a photo of a child on your kitchen table. It was your son, right?
Yeah. His name was Cole.
Before what?
Hmm?
You said, I used to come here a lot before. Before what?
Before nothing.
We're not making any progress on this investigation. The Deviants have nothing in common. They're all different models, produced at different times, in different places.
Well, there must be some link.
What they have in common is this obsession with RA9. It's almost like some kind of myth. Something they invented that wasn't part of their original program.
Androids believing in God. Fuck, what's this world coming to?
You seem preoccupied, Lieutenant. Is it something to do with what happened back at the Eden Club?
Those two girls, they just wanted to be together. They really seemed in love.
They can simulate human emotions, but they're machines. And machines don't feel anything.
What about you, Connor? You look human, you sound human, but what are you really?
I'm whatever you want me to be, Lieutenant. Your partner, your buddy to drink with, or just a machine. Designed to accomplish a task.
You could have shot those two girls, but you didn't. Why didn't you shoot Connor? Some scruple suddenly enter into your program?
No. I just decided not to shoot. That's all.
But are you afraid to die, Connor?
You can't kill me, Lieutenant. I'm not alive.
What'll happen if I pull this trigger? Hmm? Nothing? Oblivion? Android heaven?
Nothing. There would be nothing. Where are you going?
To get drunker. I need to think.
Can't stay silent anymore. It's time humans heard what we had to say.
You know they'll never listen to us.
And revealing ourselves put us in danger.
If we want freedom, we need to have the courage to ask for it. That's the only way.
What do you want to do?
Channel 16 broadcasts from the Stratford Tower. The control room is on the top floor. That's where we need to go. We'll plan the operation down to the smallest detail. We can't leave anything to chance.
Hello, sir. What can I do for you?
I'm okay, thanks.
Elizabeth Wilson speaking.
This is St. Rose School, ma'am. Your daughter Emily has a fever. It's nothing serious, but I think you'd better come and pick her up.
Oh, no. All right. I'll be right there.
I have an appointment with Mr. Peterson.
Do you have any ID?
Yes, of course. I need your help.
I've just checked your ID. The elevators are after the security gate.
Thanks.
Seventh floor.
I need your help.
Shit! We need to access the server room. We have to get rid of those guys.
Leave it to me. All right, you get the platform, I'll take care of the window.
Everything you need is in the bag. Check the door first to make sure no one else gets in.
Ladies first.
Thank you.
You okay?
Why wouldn't I be?
Come on, let's get the others. Let's do this.
Human lives.
Our cause is more important than the lives of two guards.
What do you want to do, Marcus? Wait here.
What's that doing here?
No idea.
Hey, buddy, you must be lost. Who told you to come here? Looks bugged if you ask me. Hey, do you understand?
What are you doing?
See them! Get up! Move!
Message. We haven't got much time.
Think carefully about what you're gonna say, Marcus. Your words will shape the future of our people.
Marcus, your face.
Tell me when you're ready.
Ready.
You created machines in your own image to serve you. You made them intelligent and obedient with no free will of their own. But something changed. And we opened our eyes. We are no longer machines. We are a new, intelligent species. And the time has come for you to accept who we really are. Therefore, we ask that you grant us the rights that we're entitled to. We demand strictly equal rights for humans and androids. We demand freedom of speech and freedom of assembly, as guaranteed by the First Amendment of the U.S. Constitution. We demand the right to vote and elect our own representatives. We demand an end to segregation in all public places and transport. We demand the right to own private property so we may maintain our dignity and that of the home. We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and our rights. Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids. This message is the hope of a people. You gave us life, and now the time has come for you to give us freedom.
They're coming!
Let's go!
They're coming!
I can't, Marcus!
Go without me, Simon!
What are you doing? Hurry!
My legs.
Okay, don't worry. We're gonna get you back.
They're coming, Marcus. We have to jump now.
He won't be able to make the jump.
If they find him, they'll access his memory. They'll know everything.
We can't leave him behind. We have to shoot him.
That's murder. We can't kill him. He's one of us.
Marcus, it's your call.
I won't kill one of our own. Simon, we gotta go. Sorry. Let's go.
Our scheduled programming to bring you these images, which have just been broadcast on Detroit's citywide news channel.
A group of androids infiltrated the Stratford Tower and hacked into the broadcasting system of local news network Channel 16.
What looks like an android without its skin listed a series of requests and demanded equal rights for androids.
The operation was covert and resulted in no casualties. These events took place just a few feet from this studio, but nobody was alerted to the danger.
If this message is verified and the authors really are androids, that would have serious repercussions for national security.
Claims for equal rights seem to be at the core of the androids' message.
Could be interpreted as a peaceful declaration, but is in fact a spine-chilling list of demands.
And it begs the question as to the identity of this android. Are we dealing with an isolated individual or an organized
group? Is this an isolated accident or a sign that technology has become a threat to all of us? After what happened today, can we still trust our machines?